much for being here today. We're going to go ahead and get started. My name's Andy Brown. I'm the Travis County Judge, and I'm really excited to be here today at the Central Texas Regional Infusion Center. And with me, we've got Jay Hall, the Texas Division of Emergency Management Assistant Chief for Region 6. Melissa Haymaker, the CATRAC, which is Capital Area Trauma Regional Advisory Council Interim Executive Director. Dr. Jason Pickett, the EMS Deputy Medical Director, and Vanessa Fuentes, the Austin City Council member. And we're just going to talk a little bit about the purpose of the infusion center that you see here behind me, how it's been running since it opened last week, and our region's overall COVID response plan. In Travis County, we keep seeing record-breaking numbers of new cases reported and percentage of COVID patients in our hospitals. On top of that, one of the biggest challenges that we're facing in the community is the high number of people in the ICU. This infusion center plays a critical role in helping the most at-risk people who get COVID-19 to stay healthy and not have their symptoms escalate to where they have to go to the hospital or the ICU. This is going to help save lives and it'll help hospitals be able to serve all patients in our region. And I want to thank TDEM, CATRAC, the City of Austin, and Travis County for the collaboration and hard work it took to make this happen, and Austin Public Health, of course. And then I'm going to say this in Spanish before handing it over to Jay Hall in a second. So, hola, soy el juez del condado de Travis, Andy Brown, y estoy aquí hoy en el Centro Regional de Infusión de Texas Central, junto con todos los representantes de las organizaciones que hicieron este centro una realidad. En el condado de Travis, seguimos viendo nuevos récords en la cantidad de nuevos casos de COVID y el porcentaje de pacientes con COVID en los hospitales. Además de eso, uno de los mayores desafíos que enfrentamos en nuestra comunidad es la gran cantidad de personas en la unidad de cuidados intensivos. Este centro de infusión va a ser fundamental para ayudar a las personas que contraen el COVID-19 con riesgo mantenerse saludables y no tener síntomas que se convierten en necesitar ir al hospital, lo que salvará vidas y ayudará a los hospitales a atender a todos los pacientes. Gracias a todas las organizaciones y socios aquí el día de hoy por la colaboración para hacer este centro una realidad. And now I'm going to hand it over to Assistant Chief Jay Hall from the Texas Division of Emergency Management. Thank you, Jay.
And Judge, thank you for having us here today. We really appreciate it. The Texas Division of Emergency Management is supporting 11 infusion sites across the state at the request of local officials. We are very excited to partner with Austin Public Health, CATRAC, Travis County, the City of Austin to support this infusion site. Thank you.
Hi, my name's Melissa Haymaker. I'm the Interim Executive Director for the Capital Area of Texas Regional Advisory Council. We are very thrilled to see that this Regional Infusion Center is up and operating. We know that it's going to help reduce some of the burden off of our hospitals and taking some of the infusion patients. We have been working to expand the operations here so that we can take more patients and referrals. And we are just thrilled to be working with all of our partners and making this happen.
I'm Dr. Jason Pickett, the alternate public health authority and deputy EMS medical director. This infusion center is operating as a collaboration from all the way from the governor's office through the TDEM, as well as CATRAC and Austin Public Health. We also have our hospitals to thank as well, Ascension, Seton, HCA, and Baylor Scott & White for assisting us in supplying this resource. It's our hope that this resource will help to decrease the number of patients that are hospitalized from this disease. We know, however, that the need far outstrips what we have available. We are working continuously to increase this capacity, not only at this infusion center, but also to get teams to nursing homes, and to those who are bedbound and unable to come here in order that they may also benefit from these infusions. Thank you.
Hi everyone, I'm Vanessa Fuentes, Austin City Councilwoman for District 2, and I want to thank our partners today for bringing this infusion center to Southeast Travis County. It is incredibly important. Right now, we are in a surge of COVID cases. We are experiencing high case rates. So having this infusion center open could not have come at a better time. I want to thank our partners, especially, and our county judge, Andy Brown, for his leadership on this, because the intentionality of bringing it here to this site in our southeastern quadrant was absolutely critical. We have over 8,000 cases here in Southeast throughout this entire pandemic. 8,000 of them have been in Southeast Travis County, over 8,000. So this, having it located here is important because it gives us accessibility. It addresses access to transportation. We have this great parking lot. It really centers it in the areas of Austin and Travis County that have been disproportionately affected by coronavirus. We know that this pandemic has not affected everyone equally, and for many in our Black and Brown communities, we have seen the disproportionate effects. And so by bringing this infusion center, by giving our communities the treatment needed, life that could be potentially life-saving, is absolutely critical. And I'm so thrilled to see the partnership and the collaboration from the state to the county to the local level. That's the type of leadership we need, and what I hope to continue seeing as we get through this pandemic and as we work on the recovery efforts. Thank you.
So thanks. We'll just open it up to any questions. As you can see, the center has expanded out. We're working on expanding capacity. If you want any details about that, just, I guess, raise your hand and we can call up anybody. Yeah. Perfect. Dr. Pickett?
So the current capacity is 24 per day. We're rapidly moving up to 75 per day to be treated at this center. We're also opening a call center to accept referrals from community physicians. As we know that there is an extremely limited amount of this drug available and spaces available, we started by making space for our most vulnerable citizens. Those who don't have insurance, those who don't have a primary care physician, those who get care through our federally qualified health centers. As we get this call center running and our capacity ramps up, then we can take more patients from a regional basis from our physicians and hospitals here. The infusion itself, or the process, takes about 2.5 hours. It's about a half hour for check-in, processing paperwork, and getting consent and starting the IV. The infusion itself is 1 hour, and then the patient is monitored for an additional hour after that to make sure that there are no adverse reactions. We opened on Wednesday of last week, and we are, but by the time the call center opens at the beginning of next week, we hope to be at the 75 around that point.
We have reported that hospitals had some doses they weren't able to administer. Do we, are there extra untouched doses that you guys have here? What kind of number are we looking at?
Excellent question. So, yes, the hospital infusion centers, they started with administering this drug. However, it's a balance, because everybody that they devote to the infusion center at the hospital then is not available to take care of hospitalized patients during this surge. So we took those extra doses off of their hands to stand this up, to make sure that we have a steady supply. The hospitals have been great in helping to assure us that we have a steady supply stream of the drug.
And who's staffing this?
It is a contractor that works for the state, so the state did the mission assignment, and all the staff that are here administering the infusions are contractors. We also have members of TDEM and CATRAC that are doing administrative duties and running the operation.
We know in El Paso, they were doing some of the
We're looking at ways that we can expand the operation, not only here, but also throughout the region. And with that in mind, we're looking at places that we can get this closer to where our communities live. I would prefer not to see all the infusion centers here in the city of Austin. I'd like to see us branching out further into the community and the surrounding counties. But we're still evaluating all of those options and looking at different sites. So the alternate care site, the convention center, patient care area that has opened up this week, that is there to decompress the hospitals of patients who are, they're getting better, but they're not ready to be discharged yet from the hospital. So the ACS decompresses the hospital in that way. This infusion center helps the hospitals by making it less likely that a high-risk patient would ever have to be hospitalized in the first place. To be answered in Spanish. Or?
Yeah. You want to do it?
Yeah, Okay, este center es para tratar a las personas que tienen el coronavirus. Pueden venir aquí si ya has probado positivo por coronavirus, el COVID. Puedes venir aquí para recibir tratamiento que puede salvar tu vida. Este tratamiento te van a poner para que puedes ¿cómo se dice? Pelear con el virus y que tienes de la estamina y las cosas necesarias para sobrevivir y para mejorarse. Y también es importante venir aquí porque si vienes aquí a este center, no vas a necesitar estar en el hospital. Este es otro opción que no es hospital, pero aquí puedes ganar el tratamiento. What was the first
part? De qué manera bajará los casos de COVID? De qué manera bajará?
Sí, nosotros sabemos para nuestra comunidad, el coronavirus nos está afectando mucho más que otras comunidades, porque para nosotros tenemos condiciones como diabetes, obesidad, asma, las condiciones que están más común en nuestra comunidad. Entonces cuando contagiamos el COVID nos pasa más mal y este tratamiento nos va a ayudar porque vamos a recibir el tratamiento que nos van a ayudar a sobrevivir el coronavirus. So, eso es muy importante aquí en este lugar que está central en el sureste de Austin. Es otra opción, puedes tomar Cap Metro para venir para acá. Puedes llamar si necesitas ayuda con viaje, por favor, llamas y podemos ayudarse también. Gracias.
Demand?
The demand is high. As I said before, we've started off by taking patients primarily from Austin Public Health testing rolls and community care, because these are patients that are more likely to have barriers to resources such as healthcare and insurance and that, and are most vulnerable. Also, they tend to be, they're more likely to be people of color, which have been disproportionately affected by this. We know that there's a lot more demand out there from our community physicians, what they're telling us. We have been, any space that's any slots that go unfilled, we reach out to the hospitals to try to get any overflow from them as well, so that we can get this to as many people as possible. But the demand is definitely more than what we can give right now.
Can you say how many doses we have at this time and how many more you expect to be getting?
Well, we've given over 120 doses at this point, it's difficult to say how many more we'll have to give, as this is an ongoing pandemic, and we have to see where we go. But Certainly right now, with uncontrolled spread throughout the community, then we expect to continue to have high demand for this. Patients do not have to be referred by another healthcare provider if they've been tested through Austin Public Health. Then our epidemiology nurses who reach out to those patients will then refer them. Patients from community care, People's Community Care, our federally qualified health centers, they are being referred by healthcare providers. And of course, anyone that we get from the hospital testing rolls has been referred by a doctor as well. This is not a walk-up site, so it's not the place where somebody could just say, I have COVID, walk up and say, I want to get one of these infusions. They do have to be enrolled in order to come. We have not been specifically with our patients that come through our APH testing rolls. The patients who are referred by community cares or other providers, they're following up with their providers. So the breakdown of the racial and ethnic breakdown of cases that we have is on our dashboard at austintexas.gov/COVID-19. We have dashboards there, and we break down all the cases by age, gender, race, ethnicity, and all of that. And we have throughout this pandemic, and you can see the trends there. My message to the community is that we are not powerless. The things that we do as individuals is what's going to help stop the spread here. And that includes wearing our masks, staying out of public gatherings and staying away from public settings, washing our hands, staying home when we're sick and not carrying the virus to others. These are the tools that are in our hands, and as our vaccination effort is ramping up, when that becomes available, getting that vaccination. That's what's going to help bring a stop to this whole pandemic. The people are not powerless. Those individual acts, that is what will prevent the spread of this disease. And that's what we are asking our communities to do.
All right. Any more questions? All right. So thank you all very much for coming today. The goal here is to let people know that we're investing in Southeast Travis County, that we're working with the state and the city and the county and all of our local partners together. And that please keep wearing your mask. Whenever you're not with people with whom you live, you need to be wearing a mask. That's the bottom line. Thank you very much. Gracias.